Good day, everyone. We will be talking about Republic Act 11332, or the Mandatory Reporting of Notifiable Diseases and Health Events of Public Health Concern Act. RA 11332 aims to protect people from public health threats through the efficient and effective disease surveillance of diseases of public health concern. It also aims to establish effective mechanisms for strong collaboration with national and local government, health agencies, to ensure proper procedures are in place to promptly respond to reports of notifiable diseases and health events of public health concern, including case investigations, treatment and control and containment, including follow-up activities. The Department of Health and its local counterparts are mandated to implement the mandatory reporting of notifiable diseases and health events of public health concern, among others. Section 7 of the said RA provides that the President of the Republic of the Philippines shall declare a state of public health emergency in the event of an epidemic of national and/or international concern which threatens national security in order to mobilize governmental and non-governmental agencies to respond to the threat. To better understand RA 11332, let's define first the terms used in the said act. Disease is an illness due to a specific toxic substance, occupational exposure or infectious agent which affects a susceptible individual, either directly or indirectly, as from an infected animal or person, or indirectly through an intermediate host, vector, or the environment. A notifiable disease is a disease that by legal requirements must be reported to the public health authorities. The mandatory reporting is an obligatory reporting of a condition to local or state health authorities as required for notifiable diseases, epidemics, or public health events of public health concern. An epidemic outbreak is an occurrence of more cases of disease than normally expected within a specific place or group of people over a given period of time. Health event of public health concern refers to either a public health emergency or a public health threat due to biological, chemical, radionuclear, and environmental agents. These are the punishable acts stated in the RA 11332. Unauthorized disclosure of private and confidential information pertaining to a patient's medical condition or treatment, tampering of records, intentionally providing misinformation, non-operation of the disease surveillance and response systems by responsible persons or entities mentioned under this IRR. Disclosure of confidential information will not be considered violation of this act if the disclosure was made to comply with a legal order issued by a court of law with competent jurisdiction. In addition to the punishable acts, non-cooperation of persons and entities that should report notifiable diseases or health events of public concern. Non-cooperation of persons and entities that should respond to notifiable diseases or health events of public concern. Non-cooperation of the person or entities identified as having the notifiable disease and non-cooperation of the person or entities affected by a notifiable disease or a health event of public health concern. When an individual does not self-quarantine in case of infection, he or she may be liable under Section 9 of RA 11332. For non-cooperation of persons and entities that should report or respond to notifiable diseases or health events of public concern. Penalties: this act shall be penalized with a fine of not less than 20,000 pesos but not more than 50,000 pesos or imprisonment of not less than 1 month but not more than 6 months or both such fine and imprisonment at the discretion of the proper court. The Professional Regulation Commission shall have the authority to suspend or revoke the license to practice of any medical professional for any violation of this act. If the offender is a foreign national, the case shall be referred to the Bureau of Immigration for the institution of summary deportation proceedings after service of sentence. The Civil Service Commission shall have the authority to suspend or revoke the civil service eligibility of a public servant who is in violation of this act. If the offense is committed by a public or private health facility, institution, agency, corporation, school, or other juridical entity duly organized in accordance with law, the chief executive officer, president, general manager, or such other officer in charge shall be held liable. In addition, the business permit and license to operate of the concerned facility, institution, agency, corporation, school, or legal entity shall be cancelled. There are some people asking for the criminal liability or offense being incurred during the state of public health emergency or enhanced community quarantine. These are some of their questions. Dear Pao, may I know the legal basis for any possible arrest and penalty of a person under investigation for the COVID-19 who refuses to heed or cooperate with an order to self-quarantine? And this was the response from Pao. The answer to your question is found in the provisions of RA 11332, otherwise known as the Law of Reporting of Communicable Diseases. Another question. I rushed my brother to the hospital last week because of his on and off fever and persistent cough. The doctor who examined him asked for his travel history. But my brother did not inform the doctor that he went to Japan and South Korea last month, out of his fear of being identified as a carrier of the coronavirus. We are still waiting for his test results. Can my brother be held liable for not disclosing his travel history to his attending physician? And this was the answer from Pao. Any person identified as having a notifiable disease or affected by the health event of public concern, such as the coronavirus disease 2019 or COVID-19, can be held liable for concealing his travel history when asked by a health personnel during medical examination under RA 11332. In the Philippine News Agency website alone, there are a lot of articles about the alleged violators of health protocols. These are some of the articles shown in the Philippine News Agency website. For the past year, since COVID-19 pandemic started in our country, more than 200,000 cases were already filed against alleged violators. RA 11332 is currently facing a lot of issues and controversies as to its provisions and implementation. There were already trial courts that have junked charges against the alleged violators due to lack of probable cause and insufficiency of evidence. Critics have been saying that some provisions of the Act are vague and ambiguous, and that it can be possibly abused by authorities and their agents. As of now, no cases and petitions have reached the Supreme Court. Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara said that there are three specific laws as a basis for one to be validly arrested on the occasion of serious disobedience to law enforcers during the enhanced community quarantine: Article 151 of RPC on resistance and disobedience to a person in authority. If there is violence involved, Article 148 of the revised Penal Code on direct assault against an officer, and the RA number 11332 on the mandatory reporting on notifiable diseases under Section 9, which prohibits non-cooperation. That would be all.